a lot of times on the ocean, you're facing big water. So big waves, usually in the tropics, Panama, Australia, New Caledonia, India, Andaman Islands, places I've encountered tuna. Usually the seas are pretty calm, pretty fishable. Once you get off like the East Coast in the fall, Cape Cod, and you get some bigger waves, bigger conditions, you want to adjust your lures. You don't want something like a topwater popper that in 5 or 6 foot waves that when you sweep or pop that you're pulling the water or the lure off the top of the wave. You know, that just, it kills the action. The fish, they don't like that. You will never get a bite if you're pulling the popper, skipping it off the top of the wave. If you can't keep your popper in the water, you want to go to a sinking stickbait. You know, in big waves, I'm always going to have a sinking stickbait on. He's Jackfin 165, Pelagus 165, or something. I'm going to throw a lot in big waves. It stays down. It's in the water. It's still going to be natural. A tackle house Brit, same thing. You can keep it down in the water. They're heavy. I think this is 98 grams. You know, you cast it, it sinks like a rock. So big conditions, big waves, you want something that stays in the water. You don't want something that you're going to skip off the top of the wave. The fish will not hit it. And it just, it's always going to get fouled up. You start skipping it off the waves, your braid's going to get wrapped in your trebles. Always go sinking stick bait in the big water. Another thing to look for a topwater tuna lure is the quality of the lure. I always like a lure that has a through wire. You know, one continuous wire is from this line tie through these hook hangers. Because on big tuna, you know, I've had times where the tuna's actually broken in half. You know, however you get them hooked and they've had some leverage. You know, this is made out of some type of wood. I'm not sure what type of wood it is. But, you know, with enough force or leverage, this will break. Especially, you know, after 2 or 3 days of yellowfin tuna, this is all scarred up, beat up. And it can get compromised. So I look, it's a continuous wire from this line tie all the way through the inside of this lure, all the way to this hook hanger, even including this one. So if this breaks in half, you're still connected from your line to your end of your lure. That wire is not going to break. Yeah, the lure, you probably won't be able to use the lure anymore once you get it back, but you're not going to lose that fish of a lifetime using a through-wired lure. Some of the less expensive lures, they are not through-wired. So I would look for, but there are a lot of, you know, like a Halco popper, I believe, is through-wired. You know, and that's very affordable. But you do want a quality lure when you're chasing big pelagic fish, especially tuna. They're very strong. So my advice, get a through-wired lure.